Hi children, welcome back. Students, in our previous class, we discussed what resources are, classification of resources and types of resources. At the end of this topic, you will be able to learn major problems of indiscriminate use of resources, sustainable development and resource planning. As we all know that resources are vital for human survival, for maintaining quality of life. It was believed that resources are free gifts of nature, but actually not. As a result of this thinking, human beings use them indiscriminately. This has led to three major problems. Let us see. The first one is depletion of resources for satisfying the greed of few individuals. In this case, we can take the example of America. It is importing bulk of paper from underdeveloped countries like India. If the resources are depleted, all the countries may suffer. And one more example for this is petroleum. The developed countries, they're putting more pressure on fossil fuels. If they complete, they face a lot of problem. Accumulation of resources in few hands divides society into two segments, that is haves and have-nots. Rich people, they accumulate more amount of resources because they are rich, and poor could not. Indiscriminate exploitation of resources leads to global ecological crises such as global warming, ozone layer depletion, environmental pollution, and land degradation. That is why we need to have a sustainable development. An equitable distribution of resources has become essential for the sustained quality of life and global peace. So, resource planning is essential for sustainable existence of all forms of life. Let us know the definition of sustainable development. Development should take place without damaging the environment, and development in the present should not compromise with the needs of future generations. In June 1992, more than 100 heads of states met in Rio de Janeiro in Brazil for the first International Earth Summit. These leaders, they addressed the urgent problems of environmental protection and socio-economic development at global level. And all the leaders signed the Declaration on Global Climatic Change and Biodiversity in the first International Earth Summit. These people, they endorsed the Global Forest Principles and adopted Agenda 21 for achieving sustainable development in the 21st century. Let us know what is Agenda 21. It is nothing but it's a declaration signed by world leaders in 1992 at the United Nations Conference on Environment and Development, UNICET. This was also took place in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. The main agenda of this Agenda 21 is that to combat with environmental damage, poverty, this is through global cooperation on common interests, mutual needs and shared responsibilities. So this Agenda 21 aims to achieve global sustainable development. One of its major objectives is that every local government should draw its own local agenda for every country. Resource planning. As I told you earlier, An equitable distribution of resources has become essential for sustained quality of life. For that, we need to plan our resources. So resource planning is widely accepted strategy for judicious use of resources. It has an importance of which in a country like India, which has enormous diversity in the availability of resources. There are certain regions which are rich in certain types of resources but are deficient in some other types of resources. Let us see. Here we can see Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh. These states are rich in minerals and coal deposits. Arunachal Pradesh. This state is abundance in water resources but lacking in infrastructure. Rajasthan. This state has endowed with solar and wind energy but lacking in water resources. Finally, Ladakh. It's a totally isolated area from the rest of the country. It has a very rich cultural heritage but it has deficient in water, infrastructure and some other vitamin minerals. But rich in cultural heritage. Resource planning in India. Resource planning is a complex process which involves identification and inventory of resources across the regions of the country. This involves surveying, mapping, qualitative and quantitative estimation, measurement of resources. We need to survey and map the quality of resources and its quantity, estimation and measurement of resources. Evolving a planning structure endowed with appropriate technology, skill and institutional setup for implementing resource development plans. It means we need to have appropriate technology and skill and institutional setup like companies and industries for converting the resources into more qualitative products. And now we need to match those resources for the development plans with overall national development plans. Students, there are many regions in our country that are rich in resources, but these are included in economically backward regions. On the contrary, there are regions which have poor resource base, but they are economically developed. Therefore, resources can contribute to development only when they are accompanied by appropriate technological development and institutional changes. Irrational consumption and overutilization of resources may lead to socio-economic and environmental problems. We all know that resources are vital for any developmental activity. But due to this, some greedy people, they are overutilizing these resources. That is why the great leader and the father of our nation, Gandhiji, said that there is enough for everybody's need and not for anybody's greed. He placed the greedy and selfish individuals and exploitative nature of modern technology as the root cause for resource depletion at the global level. He was surely against mass production and wanted to replace it with the production of the masses. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. We'll meet in the next class.